A national task force tackling Australia's ice crisis has turned its attention to our state's southeast. It's heard harrowing tales of how the deadly drugs spread through Mount Gambier, but also from locals with suggestions about how they can band together to fight it. Gia Loukes filed this report.
A range of people from varying backgrounds have taken part in the National Ice Task Force's first community consultation here in Mount Gambier. We only had to walk down the main street to get a scary insight into the problem here, hearing from locals whose lives have been torn apart by the drug.
Ice has taken almost everything from this Mount Gambier mother of four.
I was 12 or 13 when I first started.
Her addiction so bad, her children have been placed in state care. But she's one of the luckier ones.
I've seen three people die with it, and I've had quite a few people I've had to save with it too.
Mount Gambier is one of many Australian cities struggling to cope with the ice scourge. It's the first community stop for the National Ice Task Force. Among the witnesses, Karen Judd, who founded a parent support group when her son Jay died from a methamphetamine overdose.
It changed him from a very loving, gentle person into, at times I would think the devil had walked in the door.
She wants to see an ice crisis centre built in Mount Gambier.
Don't underestimate it. This drug has the power to take away the love that the addicts have for their own family.
About 200,000 Australians have used ice in the past 12 months. Imports have also exploded, from 5% of those detected in 2011 to 59% last year. Bikies dominating the market.
Another recent shift as well has been the use of the internet and the postal service to bring ice into the community, and that's another dimension.
In Mount Gambier, locals say the close-knit nature of the community is fueling the spread.
It's everywhere. You can find it no matter where you go.
The sad thing about being ice in this town is affecting that many teenagers before they even have normal life experiences, before they even get a chance to see what life's about.
The number of people receiving medical treatment across the country has more than doubled since 2010.
It's scary. You've got a person who is totally irrational. They have the strength of, you know, far exceeding their body size.
Confronting ad campaigns have hit screens this week. The National Task Force promising to have interim recommendations by the end of next month. It's hoped the closeness of Mount Gambier's community will now help break the ice.
I mean, it's about time the community starts standing up and saying something too. If we all join together with the government and community to get it off the streets, then it'll be the best thing.
The task force will visit Darwin, Mildura and Newcastle in coming weeks.